of time to be able to do it. Not a lot of time. You see that in about 2 or 3 weeks. And again, please, quiet. There's no class. Quiet. Thank you. Next week, there's no class. It's a lunch break. So don't forget, don't come to school. Or I won't be here. Okay. So that being said, what did you say? Oh, you guys are
here.
Okay, let's go.
So, did you see the meeting between Trudeau and Obama today at the White House?
Yeah, well, that's a good point. Actually, I was listening to it while I was doing my exercise. I was listening to the speech by quiet. Thank you. He's asking a very good question. Maybe you guys don't care, but it's a very interesting, meeting. And this is the first time, you know, after 20 years that you have something like that. And you can see the warmth, you know, between Obama and Justin Trudeau. And in fact, too, it's okay, guys, I will help you, don't worry. And it's so nice to see what they're talking about. Because some of the things they're talking about is something that's going to affect us. I'm not sure how many people know what they're talking about. Anybody know what Justin Trudeau and then the president were talking about?
Financing.
I'm sorry?
Financing?
Yeah, one of these,
yeah,
because of the environment, climate change.
They welcome in warehouse.
Yeah, you talk of that warehouse, apart from the climate change, what are you talking about? Yeah.
International trade and growth of the economy.
Well, of course, don't forget, you know, I mean, Canada is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, trading partner we have in the United States. Every day, there's about 2 billion worth of trade going back and forth. And in fact, the president too was giving the stats as to how many cars and trucks cross over. And besides, I mean, without the United States being our trading partner, it's going to be very difficult for Canada to survive. I'm telling you right now. And that is why that relationship is extremely very, very important. Apart from that trade, you talk about lumber. Talk of that one too. That one is extremely very important because don't forget, one of the trade we have in the United States is through lumber and it's coming from Vancouver. But then the problem is being the fact that the American now they've been trying to reduce some of the lumber coming from Canada, which can affect our economy, and it's affecting us a little bit right now. Thank you for that. There's so many issues, and who doesn't seem to know as a Canadian. I'm very much concerned as to what is going on. And we need to be able to know that. Okay, you can finish your school, and if you finish your school, you have a diploma, you don't have a job, you get angry and you complain and all that. But you need to know what is going on. You need to get involved. I'm not asking to run for office, but you never know. You can do that in the future. Don't sell yourself short. Very interesting, I was watching it, and I can't wait to go back home to see what's going on. Also, too, the women, Mrs. Obama and then Trudeau's wife, they have their own whatever you want to call it, on the side thing, too. And they were talking about education. You're talking about the fact that education is very important, and then they were trying to encourage, especially girls. Then they talk about this little girl, 16, it's not 17 or 18, Malala. Anybody know who's Malala?
Yeah.
Not on that side. Not from the, anyone know who's Malala on this side? Apart from you, Malala.
Wait, what?
Apart from you, Malala. You guys are what do you mean?
Specifically, he's talking to you three now.
Yeah, I'm talking to the white people. Anyway, jokes apart, Malala actually is 16 now. Was he 15 or 16 at the time? I'm sorry?
When
she got shot. I just want to know.
Then, 15.
I think it was around 15 when she got shot. Okay? Because he was trying to fight for education. And then we know that, what's the name of this group that shot? I'm sorry?
I heard of that, sir.
Okay.
We're good.
Yeah, you're good now.
We're good.
What are you trying to say?
Wasn't it the Taliban?
Yeah, Taliban, that's right. Thank you. Can you imagine that? And this girl was so determined, talking about motivation, talking about inspiration. You know, if a girl like that can be so determined, even though they wanted to kill her, now he was blind in one eye, I think, you know, but she's still determined, you know, to make sure she fight for education for young people all over the world. And if you can do it, what's wrong with you? What's wrong with one of us? Yeah.
I think it was for her 18th birthday. She was honored through some big funding campaign or something. They built a, it was an education foundation specifically for women.
Yeah.
Like to help, you know, further progress or movement.
That's
that
amazing.
Was it. Yeah, it was
yeah.
Like it was really cool. I read it.
In fact, she addressed the UN, United Nations. I mean, that's a huge organization, and for her at that age to be able to do that, to me, that's very courageous. You know, it's an inspiration. If I think of her now, she seems to stand on the same level with Nelson Mandela, you know, Dr. Martin Luther King, all those great, great people, based on what you know, she's doing, what she stands for. And this is supposed to be an inspiration to all of us.
Mm-hmm.
If a girl like that can do it, then what's something all about? Okay? Thank you for being there.
But Bruce Jenner won Woman of the Year, so. Right? Just be
like, society has all of its things backwards.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
That's the stupidest thing. My remote was dying. My little brother was sitting in front of the TV changing it, like that far away. I'm like, there's fucking buttons. Like, if you're gonna be right there. Kids when they piss me off. Cool. Done with that.
What's strange? My dad would make that movement, but I'd end up on the back of his hand.
So at a very young age, you were already into science,
yeah.
Is it? Transfer of kinetic energy. That's why kids don't know shit anymore. You used to get hit, you'd learn something. Nowadays, it's like,
they put me in my room, I had to play Xbox.
You have two guests who come and see your presentation. Obviously, for them to see, they want to come and see, you must have told them something. I'm not sure what you guys said, So you better do a very good job, otherwise you're in trouble. Because you invited me to come and see your presentation. Okay, give me 1 second, please. Okay, go ahead, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are group three. There are three of us right now. I'm Franklin, he's Alexander, and he's Alex Francis. Our topic is terrorism. These are the main.
Wait a minute, go back. Go. Where do you guys get your name from? Alex Anthony and Alex Francis and Franklin Anto. And you guys are from India?
Yeah.
Really? And this is your real name?
Yeah.
on your ID?
No.
Yeah. It's only me.
On the ID?
Yeah.
Okay. No, this is the first time. It's either Patel or you know, Upa, Santa, you know, you don't see Anthony and Alex. Okay, is that name given to you at birth or?
Yes.
No, seriously, I just want to know.
It's because we are Christians. Christians in India gave them, we take the Western names.
Oh, really? Oh, in India. No, that's new to me, seriously. That is very, very new. So that's why I'm kind of
questioning. It hasn't started up or something.
Okay. Thank you.
So, these are the main comments that we are going to cover in our presentation. First one is the definition of terrorism and types of terrorism, how the terrorists are defined, and the top 5 terrorist groups in our world, the major terrorist attacks, and Canadian anti-terrorism act, Bill C-24, and some solutions that we think can reduce the terrorism to some extent. And the definition of terrorism. Terrorism actually comes from the Latin word fear. And according to FBI, the definition for terrorism is the unlawful use of force against person or property to intimidate or coerce a government, the civilian population, in furtherance of political or social objectives. It's a bit complex definition. In simple words, the definition of terrorism is the use of violence or threat of violence, especially against a civilian, for gaining a particular goal. And these people are not worried about their life, and they want to take others' life. They strongly believe that violence or threat will be effective for getting back their rights or change the world. And the types of terrorism. In early 1975, the Law Enforcement Assistant Administration United States formed the National Advisory Committee on Criminal Justice Standards and Codes. The committee classified terrorism into 6. These are the 6 types of terrorism: civil disorder, political terrorism, non-political terrorism, quasi-terrorism, limited political terrorism, and state terrorism. First one is civil disorder. Civil disorder is a violent form of protest held by a group of individuals, usually in opposition to a political policy or action. Protests are intended to be non-violent, but they do sometimes result in large riots in which private property is destroyed and civilians are injured or killed. So this civil disorder, they are intended to send a message to the political group that people are unhappy and they demand change. The next one is political terrorism. Defined as the definition for political terrorism is an act initiated internally, which means citizens of the same country, or externally, international terrorists who are opponents of the target nation's national or political beliefs. This type of terrorism is common in neighboring countries with disputes related to territory, national sovereignty, and use of natural resources. In certain parts of the world, like Middle East, Africa, and Eastern Europe, this kind of terrorism may be ongoing for a long period of time.
What will you say is the difference between the first two, political terrorism and then the civil disobedience?
First one, They are intended to send a message. They are a group of people within the country. They are intended to send a message to the political group that the people are unhappy and they demand change. The first one, civil.
But then you say the first one too, actually, if you see right there, they say that usually in opposition to a political policy or action.
Yeah, that's the first one.
Right.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, how is that one different then from the second one?
The second one is political one. It is actually a political act that comes from international terms mainly, but it also happens internally with the citizens of the same country against a national policy or belief.
Okay. All right.
And not political terrorism. This is act of violence by fanatics due to religion, cultural, or ideological reasons. Regardless of the motive, this type of terrorism may be extremely violent, threatening a nation's social stability, while it frequently leads to loss of life, torture, and conflicts among social groups.
Do you have an example of that?
Yeah.
Of non-political terrorists due to religion, cultural, or ideological reasons?
They are done mainly based on the ideological reasons or religion, cultural reasons. And this one is very dangerous act. These terrorists are willing to sacrifice their lives and the lives of people they love for their cause.
Well, it is true. I'm asking if you have any concrete example. Yeah, concrete example of what kind of group might be considered to be non-political.
Al-Qaeda.
I'm sorry?
The Al-Qaeda group. Okay. ISIS.
Where is this?
They are the main terrorist group, like non-political one, based on like religion or certain ideas.
Okay, any other group?
Taliban.
Okay, the Taliban can be an example.
Okay.
Because
they are based on religion or cultural or ideological base.
So the Taliban, what did they do then?
Actually, we're going to cover that in our presentation later.
Okay. All right. I'm just asking ahead of time to see if you know it.
Okay.
It's okay. Go ahead.
And the next one is quasi-terrorism is a violent act that utilizes the same method terrorist employ, but that does not have the same motivating factors. Meaning, the lawbreaker is acting in a similar manner to a terrorist, but the terrorism is not his goal. We have an example here: an armed criminal who is trying to escape from a law enforcement, utilizing civilians as a hostage to help them escape. In this example, the person here, the armed criminal, is trying to evade the police or escape, and he is using the same method of a terrorist group, but different. The goal is different. That's what's meant by quasi-terrorism. The next one is limited political terrorism. Act of terrorism which are committed for ideological or political motives, but which are not part of planned campaign or to capture control of the state. So the goal is not to overthrow the government, but to protest against a political policy or action. It is less violent act of protest against a political regime, decision, or strategy. The last one is the state terrorism. An aggressive behavior started by a current political regime against another nation or political minority in order to obtain a specific objective. We have some examples here: access to natural resources, violation of principle of the territorial integrity to promote border changes. Commonly, state terrorism involves in a conflict with another country. Usually, state terrorism leads to warfare among nations, with human rights abuses and civilian casualties.
Okay, what are you saying? That go back. Okay, the first paragraph. It says an aggressive behavior started by current, what do you mean by current political regime? It's a current. I'm trying to understand. Is that the government itself, or what do you mean by current political?
It can be like people or opposition to the government. opposition party.
Okay, oh, you're referring to opposition party?
Yeah.
Okay. Against another nation or political minority. Okay, go on.
Next one, how the terrorists are getting money for weapons and for terrorist activities. Here are some methods used to raise money. Fake charities, donations and gift, drugs, smuggling and prostitution, robberies, kidnapping and ransoms. These are the main fundraising methods for terrorism. Next slide is going to cover that.
In fact, if you go back, because it's time for us to understand, because terrorism is something very common in Canada too. We have some groups, okay, in our West that they're known to be, you know, part of terrorism. In fact, there's a case in Windsor, I'm not sure how many people read it. There was a guy that worked for MCC. MCC is called the, can you help me put this back down? MCC is called the Multicultural Council of Windsor. There's a guy that works there, and then this guy was recently fired just last week because he wrote an article on one of the newspapers right here in Windsor, and the article is claiming that this guy more or less is trying to kind of really promote terrorism. So that is why it's so important for us to know. And then I like what you said in the first line, fake charities, because now it's so easy in this country. There's so many, many groups that starting a, you know, a non-profit organization to raise money. And that money now is being sent abroad to kind of, you know, fund all this event. That is why it's very important for people to know. When people are calling you or asking you to give money, you have to be very careful. You know, what kind of people are they? What kind of group are they? Are they recognized by the government? And then what's the money being used for? Because there's so many fake people that will call your home asking for donation. So it's nice to know that. And then they involve in drug smuggling and prostitution. Okay. Hmm. Okay, do you have an example of that? Drug smuggling and prostitution? No? Okay. Well, because we know there's so many. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
Wait.
Yeah, you.
Just to add, drug smuggling and prostitution. A lot of Middle Eastern countries have a very high export of opium, which is cultivated and grown. It's not really allowed over here, but it's used in a lot of like perfumes and stuff like that as a sub extract. However, it's also one of the main ingredients in heroin. Mm-hmm. So they subsidize that product and sell it to Mexico, which where they refine it, and then it comes up in Canada and the States, and then that's where they make their profit on that.
Yeah, that's a very, very good point. True opium. Okay, Afghanistan, we know they're very common in that one. And so many Asian countries, through opium, that's how they get money from cocaine. And cocaine is very, very important. That's what I was asking you. And in fact, too, when you talk about prostitution, we know there's so many girls from Western world. When I say Western world, I'm talking about Canada, United States. They purposely travel to all these places, and guess what they do there? Okay, prostitution, and then they get them pregnant, having kids. Okay, that's one of the ways too they try to be able to kind of really get, you know, money for that purpose. So it's nice to know, because when you're talking about all this, it's time for you to have an example, okay, as to how they get the money, what's smuggling all about, and all that. Of course, we know kidnapping. Go to Africa right now. Hey, don't go yet. I ain't asking to go anywhere. In Africa, I will tell you right now, that's why they warn all the people traveling to all these countries in Africa to be very careful, because kidnapping is one of the ways they're trying to make their money. Once you get kidnapped by somebody from Western world, they'll be asking for millions of dollars before they can release you. It's a very, 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 very common, you know, event, kidnapping, which is very important. And then what they do is, once they kidnap you, they'll be asking for the second point, ransom, okay, which is a lot of money. Okay, go ahead.
Yep. Here we have a human casualty showing the number of death rates during different years due to different terrorist attacks all over the world. As we all know, like in 2006, the death rate The rate was like 20,487. While we moved into 2007, it was very huge, like 22,719. And the years have passed away, the terrorist attacks have been came to a little bit decrease. And when it reached to 2013, it was like, it got a huge increment, like 17,891.
So is it going up or is it going down?
It's going up.
Because it was up in 2007.
Yeah.
You can use that thing. What's that thing? Yeah. You can give it to him. The red one, you can point to it. Yeah, the red one. If point to it. The red. Do you press it?
Okay.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So it'd be nice to see. So in 2007 it's high?
Yeah, 2007 it's very high. And when it comes to 2008, it starts decreasing. And while going to 2012, it's still decreasing. When it came to 2013, it was like 17,891. Mm-hmm. Again, it increased.
That's interesting.
Here is a attack. It's used in terrorist attacks worldwide. It's a pie chart representing how they are doing the terrorist attacks. There are different kinds of methods they used for terrorist attack. Like one of the most common method they use for terrorist attack is bombing explosion. That's like they use there are the when we consider the world, there are 57% they use bomb explosions for doing the terrorist attacks. And other thing is after that it's armed assault. They are using like different kinds of weapons to do the terrorist attack. That's just 23%. And the other thing is assassinations. That's just 8%. And the rest of the two are almost like 6%. Like facility infrastructure attack and the hostage taking.
Okay, when you talk about extortion, because that one is 57%.
Yeah,
what does that mean?
It's like bombing. Means, you can take the example of World Trade Center, which had like they did in the New York night.
Well, bombing because extortion is when you kick people out.
Explosion.
Yeah.
Explosion.
Explosion. Oh, explosion.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I can't see very well.
Oh,
it's explosion.
Okay. Like as we all know, there are like large number of terrorist groups in the world, but here I'm going to discuss the top five terrorist groups in the world. They are the Al-Qaeda, Taliban, Lashkar-e-Toyba, ISIS, Boko Haram. So now we are going to discuss a little bit about each of the groups. Here is Al-Qaeda. The founder of Al-Qaeda group is Osama bin Laden and Abdul Azam and other militants. The Al-Qaeda's objective is to unite the Muslims across the world in the global jihad and a strict interpretation of the